Gravcast the 13th. Boys, it's getting a little spooky up in here, guys. Yeah, the strobe made Wooly look like full rave vibes. How we doing, guys? My apologies for last week for I guess I didn't drink cocaine energy and I fell asleep for our nightcast and we couldn't get it going for when we originally wanted to do this. Don't worry, guys.
It was weird. I
got it.
I was at Acme at like 10 o'clock and I was like, wait, weren't we supposed to Gravcast tonight?
Oh, yeah.
So like, I didn't remember the whole night. Like we could have did it at like 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock.
Yeah.
Which I didn't was remember like, till like 10:30. So it wasn't really your fault.
By that time, I was already asleep by that time. I smoked too much weed to do my podcast about smoking weed. And then I was also thinking too, on the same note, I'm like, you know, like I keep listening to our recent Gravcast. I'm like, we're getting a little bit better. But then I'm like, I fell asleep and we couldn't do a Gravcast. So are we getting better really in reality? You know,
I feel like we're at a stalemate right now.
No, we'll expand. We'll grow. Hey, I got the monster. I'm unleashing the beast. We're good. Like, you know.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Zero calorie, I see.
Yeah. I can't do the show. What do you? Oh, you got the bull, Wooly? Oh, man. You're riding the bull. You're flying the wings, man.
Monster.
Yeah. Do you remember like the old days of like just like circling back to cocaine energy? Going to the fucking store, seeing all the varieties of Monster that they don't even make anymore.
Yeah, well, back then, there were energy drinks were like a new market. So there was just so much money being poured into it. Like now they know what sells and they're like more conservative with it.
Right.
Back then they were like fucking any kind of energy.
They're just like Monster Assault, Monster M8, Monster Explosion.
I remember getting like shamed for drinking energy drinks in high school.
Yes, I remember that shit 100%. I remember in like middle school, my parents being like, you know, you shouldn't drink those energy drinks. But me and Wooly were like, we don't give
a fuck. Energy. Your health class teacher, he's like, I knew a kid who drank an energy drink once. He got hit by a bus.
Yeah.
And it's like, how is that because he drank an energy drink?
They're like, he drank a Red Bull and he exploded. That they just popped him right off.
Yeah, they cut out the bus part.
Yeah, it's a different, because it's different classes for every class. It's just a different ailment or something like that. He drank the energy drink and just next thing you know, he lost his scholarship. Couldn't go to college. Couldn't make it out.
Yeah, but these days, like when you like watch like Shark Tank or something and you'll see like them promote like a new soda or energy drink, they're like, they're always like, this is the hardest market to get into, blah, blah, blah. It better be zero calories, zero carbs, zero cholesterol. It's like, wait, zero? Dude,
Who the fuck is it though? I feel like the three of our heads combined, like if we really put our research and put our work to it, we could come up with like a pretty fucking cool energy drink. Why not? Like, why wouldn't we? Or how wouldn't we? You know,
nobody wants because it's the hardest brand to like build. Like, it's so hard to compete with those established brands. Like, they're so, like, cutthroat.
Yeah, like the 1%.
Like Red Bull and Monster. Monster is huge now. Monster used to be a brand that sold, like, organic fruit juices for, like, 80 years.
No shit. I didn't even know that, actually.
And then they made one energy drink, and then, like, it wasn't even called Monster. It was just called some shit. Like, it was just like an energy drink. They didn't brand it as like badass.
Yeah.
But then like people liked it a lot. And then someone was like, we got to call this Monster.
Well,
that company changed forever.
Isn't Monster big in like dirt bike culture? Like that's like where it really takes off. Like, you know, like
That's that big in that culture as much as it's just advertised in that sphere.
Right. Okay. I guess because it's extreme.
I think extreme sports people. Yeah, like people who do extreme sports, a lot of them probably drink a lot of Red Bull. But I don't think it's like part of their culture. I think it's just something forced onto them because it's like,
yeah, you know, their manager's like,
I'm sponsored by Red Bull now. Fuck yeah, I'm gonna drink a Red Bull after I like do my shit.
Or he's like, I just can't stand these more Red Bulls.
It's like NASCAR, stop drinking these Red Bulls.
Like, can I please stop drinking these Red Bulls? His manager's like, no, you fucking drink that. You drink that, you take that picture and put it on Instagram.
You seeing a dude driving a Lowe's truck. I'm sure he goes to Home Depot. Not a Lowe's truck, a Lowe's car and like NASCAR. I'm sure he goes to Home Depot every now and then.
Yeah. Do you think Tony Stewart, the Home Depot driver, is like, I just go to Pet Boys, bro. Or no, I just go to Lowe's, bro. He's like, or he does say, I just go to Pet Boys, bro. Park. And people are like, that's not even the same store, Tony. I'm sorry. He's like, I don't give a shit. Fucking A. Gravcast the 13th, guys. We made it all the way to 13. Can you believe we made it to 13 and no one's just like, can we get these guys to
stop doing this, man?
Yeah, and the people are just like, you know, what'd you say? What'd you say, Jordan?
I'm Tancast past the naked mile.
No, you're 5 casts past the naked mile, technically.
Wasn't that Gravcast 8? Yeah.
That
was Gravcast 8.
Oh, fuck. That's 8?
Yeah, Gravcast 8 was the naked mile. But I think
I see how you thought it was 3, though, because like an 8 is like basically if someone took 2 threes and put it together.
Right. If you just were,
I'm sure you're just thinking in your head, like you see a 3 in your head,
and you're just like, that's similar. No, he hears 8, but he sees the 3, basically, right?
No, I think he just thought it was Gravcast 3, the naked mile, but it was Gravcast 8.
We just rename all of our, we just fuck with people and just rename all the episodes now. We're just like Jordan Reborn, episode 12. SeaWorld sucks pilot. The first one. So the 13th. Is this like a spooky cast? Are we doing like Wooly's got the red on there? Is this gonna be like a horror cast?
I think it looks spooky on Wooly's camera.
Yeah, I'm not
too much here. I'll just make it really blue.
No, you can do it. Oh, it's even like crazy. I feel the blue was like, oh man, Wooly's about to drop the fucking record of the year. You know, like you just like are going producer mode at that point. Dude,
Wooly, I don't know why, but like I'm like getting this insanely fucking crazy vibe that you're like nasty with it on dodgeball. Like dodgeball? You're nasty with it.
Was
we've talked about me playing dodgeball. Remember when I talked about when me and Paul played dodgeball? And,
like, yes, callback to like
it was a 2v like 30, and it was all him. He was just going crazy.
But he just, you were a good partner with him. Like, if you're on his team, it's like, all right, this guy could, like, lead me.
Yeah, but it was like watching him play, watching, like, someone play Halo, but just with a dodgeball, bro.
Yeah, he just had the precision. He had it all on point.
It was just, like, headshot. Yeah. It wasn't headshot, because I remember it was duck ball, because those pussies were like, it's called duck ball, and you have to hit him below the head. If you hit him in the head, you're out.
Yes,
it's and like, oh, they come on, throw it at each other's heads anyway. Just like, yeah, fuck it. And you know you're gonna get out, but it's like, hit someone in the face, you know, get out. When you do that, it makes it where the only repercussion is you're out. So it's like, wait, I can hit someone in the face right now. The only thing that's gonna happen is I'm out.
Yeah, I'm just like, it was a bad throw. Sorry. You know, it's they're like, you were clearly you pointed at his face and like as you were throwing the ball. I meant to hit him in the chest. You said as you were throwing the ball, I'm hitting you in the face right now. I'm throwing this right at your face. And you're just like, I don't know. I really meant to hit him in the chest, like chest, face, like. I'm sorry, like, and you're just sitting there out. Like, I guess I'll just sit here. I'll sit here right in the corner, you know. I'll just be
I'm out.
Sorry.
Like, I feel like that's the worst way to fucking get embarrassed in a gym. You get hit in the fucking face with a dodgeball, and like those fucking balls, like they pick up speed in the air. Those little squishy ones.
Yeah, especially the ones that were like they weren't as big. They were like a little bit bigger than a softball, you know. They like could perfectly palm them.
Yeah, those ones would hurt. You get hit in the nuts with that, and and there was no rule for knowing the nuts.
Dude,
Jim, and the girls would aim at the nuts, man. I swear.
Jim nut shots. Do we have any fucking classic ones of those? Can we talk about gym class nut shots for a second? Anybody? Anybody? Anything?
I don't remember any specific. I don't.
I do
remember a teacher just walloping a girl in the face in handball because she was goalie.
I think a teacher also, what's it? Floor hockey. Sorry. Fucking grab mode right there. In floor hockey, went to go do like a slap shot and a student was right behind him, hit him right in the nuts. Yeah, no, not the face, the nuts. Nuts, dude. Like gym class nut shot right in the back wrist. And fuck, it was like a bit. He's like, dude, he hit me right in the balls. Like the guy was like contemplating. He's like, I feel like I should fight the gym teacher because he hit me in the nuts like this hard.
Wait, I do remember a good one. It was actually kickball.
Kickball.
It was kickball, okay. And it was right back at the pitcher, but I can't remember the fucking kid was. But he went down. It went right back at him. It was like he rolled it. He rolled it. It was just like.
Dude, Jordan, do you have just the immediate reaction too? Because you're the pitcher, you're the closest one to the kicker.
I remember it was like this was like fifth grade, I'd say, and it was like a thing because it was like we want to play kickball, bro. Like,
yeah, balls get kicked. The teacher's like, no, because one of you is gonna pitch the ball, and then someone's gonna kick it right back and hit you right in the nuts, and it's gonna be this whole big thing. And you guys are like, oh, that won't happen. That won't even happen. And then. Batter up, first kid comes up, kicks.
Everyone was trying to do it after that. Everyone was.
Oh, that became the game. We're like, yo, do you think I could hit the kicker pitcher in the nuts? Do you think I could kick the pitcher in the nuts?
Yeah, that's what happened. Kickball fucking ruled. When you had enough people for kickball, because it's just such a weird game.
It
like,
is.
You it's... always hit it. Like, who the fuck can't kick a rolling ball coming towards you? Like, how is that a...
There are those few who got out who struck out in kickball.
I've seen it. Yeah, the kickball strikeout, that's got to be like the worst feat
you can do in sports. Like, how do you come back from that? Like, I feel like if that, like, do you call your mom and like, I you have to pick me up.
I struck out in kickball today. Can you pick me up?
They're like, oh, they're like, oh, hey, are you sick right now? You're just like, no, I struck out in kickball. And your dad like overhears it. He's like, wait, give me the phone right now. He's like, what'd you do? You struck out three times. You went to kick the ball and you missed it.
It's a 20-minute class. How'd you get so many at that?
Three different times you went to kick that ball and you missed it. You're not coming home. You're just like, you are not coming home tonight at all. You stay.
You're gonna go stay with your aunt Clarice.
Yeah, she lives right by the school. You can walk.
You go knock on her door. You tell her I'm not welcome at my house anymore.
And you tell her. You tell her you went in kickball, and you went to kick the ball and missed it three times in a row. And if she doesn't even let you stay there, I can't help you. I can't even guarantee what she's gonna do for you.
You're on your own. You're on your own.
But no, of course, the kickball strikeout is the actual.
This should be that could be a villain origin story. Like, you know, people say it's something's a villain origin story.
Yes, like the kid's just like, it was gym class, 1989. Everyone's just in like the short fucking shorts and shit like that.
Yeah.
They have like the classic nerd.
Gym shoes. Like, you know how everyone had like sneakers were terrible back then? Like, they didn't have good sneakers.
Right, they all wore like tennis shoes, basically. Right,
yeah,
like, that's what they did.
Yeah, like no one had like cool sneakers. It was all just like little dumb shoes. Either way,
but like the kid, he's just there. He just has like his glasses on. You know, the classic like '80s nerd glasses where it's like squared, but they're also taped together in the center. So yeah. It's, like you're a nerd.
It also kind of says you're poor too.
Yes, yeah. Yeah, so it's like a lot of that going on. And you go up, one pitch, you totally miss. Everyone's like, what the fuck? Like, he missed again? Pitcher's like, oh, okay, that's weird. Like, throws it again. You kick and you miss it again. Everyone's like, yo, is this kid about to strike out kickball right now? Is this kid about to strike out? Everyone's like whispering in the outfield and shit. Like, they're like, do we even got to move right now? Everything. All right. Pitcher's like looking. He's like, all right, I guess I'm going to do this. I'm going to strike this kid the fuck out. Like, rolls it up, walks up, completely misses again. He Charlie Browns it. Fuck it. He Charlie Browns it. He flips. He backflips and he falls right onto his back.
He shits his pants.
He shits his pants and they're white short shorts. So everyone sees it. He shits his pants ass up in the air as he backflips. Everyone's crowd bursts in laughter. Everyone's laughing. Fuck. The principal walks in about to give him like the student of the year award. And they're like, oh, the student of the year can't shit his pants and strike out and kickball. Like, what the fuck? Everyone, like the person that he was going to ask the prom was like just laughing the hardest. Like the girl he was going to ask out, like the girl of his dreams, the girl next door type. And
this isn't high school. This has got to be like middle. This is like young kids, I'd say.
So the girl he was going to ask to his eighth grade dance.
Suck at kickball.
Yeah, something. Yeah.
Jordan, did you say you sucked at kickball?
No, like if you can't play kickball, like what's the point? Like, how do you suck at that? You're just kicking a fucking ball.
That's what we're saying. The kickball strikeout is the absolute worst thing. Have you ever seen that? It's like the saddest thing ever. It's like crazy. Like, holy shit. Like,
the kickball strikeout.
Chances.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. That's why if you kick out.
And they're just rolling it. It's a roll.
That's why we call back. If you strike out in kickball, you call your parents, your dad gets upset, tells you to go live with your aunt, and your aunt is like, you can't live here. And then you basically become a homeless kid. And then that's what starts the villain story, you know?
And then I think that villain should carry around a ball, but he just kicks it like super hard. It's fucking like just
takes
people's heads off and shit.
He kicks it at people's nuts. So that's what it is. That's what it
all comes together.
Yeah, exactly. He kicks it right at people's nuts.
He just that bounces the awesome. Ball around and drops it and then nut shots people.
Yeah.
Yeah, he just walks around. No, he walks around and like he fucking entices these people into playing.
Yeah, like, it's like a fucked up game.
He's like, hey, you mind rolling this ball to me? It's and like, they're like, what? Okay. What
it's like a
fuck?
Shitty right. Yu-Gi-Oh! Villain or some shit like that. Like,
we can turn that into a show.
I don't think we should, but I wouldn't be surprised if somebody heard this and they're like.
And did. No, out there do this.
Yeah. We're gifting this to you. We're just putting this out in the universe so it's just made one day. They just turn it into like a horror film or something like that. It just like the guy kicks it, like the fucking nuts explode. You know what I mean? Every single time. It's just like, whoa, that just me personally, even though this is Gravcast the 13th, I'm not into horror film, guys. I'm not like a big horror film guy.
Are you kidding me?
I'm not really that crazy.
Neither am I, quite honestly. I'm into psychological horror, not really like that gory horror.
What, Jordan, what would you recommend me as like a non-horror enjoyer? Like, what should I watch?
You should watch Get Out.
I enjoyed that. That's a horror movie? Or is that more like a thriller? I don't know.
It's definitely more of a thriller.
But I've seen it. I enjoy Get Out, and I saw the other one. It was Us.
Yeah,
I saw Us. Us was free. Yeah, Us I watched too.
All right, so there's a good one. It's pretty cool, and it's like light for like people that don't watch a lot of horrors. It's like these two kids, and they go to see their grandma,
right,
grandpa, and when they go to see their grandma and grandpa, like the grandma's like acting all strange and she's like sick or whatever, and grandpa's like, oh, blah blah blah, she's old, and
he's like, that's yeah, just the way the like, cookie crumbles.
He literally like the grandpa was sus too. And then they were like, oh, grandma and grandpa are being weird. And then mom was like, that's not your grandparents.
First of all, that was the most amazing way somebody's ever told me of how a movie went. The grandpa being sus was awesome. Like, you know what I mean? Like, because that can mean so many different things. That could mean something like the grand be like, is grandpa trying to like suck my dick right now? You know what I mean?
No, no, he wasn't sus like that. He was just sus like always by the shed.
I see what you mean. He was being creepy. He was like just like being like, what is grandpa doing?
Yeah. I forget what that one's called, but like it's cool that one because the way they filmed it, it's like they filmed it as a blog the whole entire time throughout.
Oh, it's like one of those. It's like or like a vlog or whatever. So it's like,
yeah,
it's like if Adam 20, it's like if Adam 22 fucking shot a horror movie, basically. Can I ask you guys something? I think this might be my favorite horror film, but I don't know if it qualifies. Is Jaws a horror film?
I think it is a action film, but it's filmed in a lot of ways in a horror kind of tone. The right. music is yeah. like horror.
It's like, and it's like,
you know, it's all filmed like a horror film.
It's like, I'm pretty fucking scared. I don't want to be in the ocean with some fucking sharks and shit. Like, come on. Is that like, I don't know. Like, that's crazy. Just being eaten by a shark. Like,
it is.
It's horrific, you know? So I'm like, I think that could be a horror film, you know? And it's like, granted, that shark too, that's not like an ordinary shark, you know? Like, they made that shark like fucking gigantic and like a fucking predator. And they kind of made it like the shark was hunting them too, you know?
They made it horrifying.
Yeah, exactly. So I don't know.
Maybe well, they were like, baiting it at the end.
True, well, yeah, at the end. Like,
I feel like you can make that same argument with Twister.
Oh, is that the fucking
Twister tornado? Twister is a horror movie too, I would say too, yeah.
That's
I love that movie, man. That was a good movie. I don't like it anymore, but when I was a little kid, I was terrified of that shit. I thought that shit was gonna happen all over the place.
That's like a late 90s.
I thought my whole life I was gonna see like a million of those tonight. I was gonna have to run from shit. I'm like, that happens? And my parents were like, yeah, but they didn't specify that like not much around here. So I'm like, oh yeah. My god.
It's like very rare around here.
It's getting windy, it's like starting to storm. I'm like,
yeah, you're just like, oh fuck. You're just like waiting for a cow to just fucking turn, like, you know, twist and turn. Like, oh,
that movie was just so fucking 90s too. Like, that's like the most 90s movie ever, I'd say.
That's the most 90s movie ever. Ooh, that's tough. I'm trying to think.
Like, that movie does not get made any other time, is what I mean. Like, it's not the best movie of the 90s, of course. It's not even, I wouldn't even consider it that good of a movie.
No, I totally get what you're saying. Not the best, but the most 90s. You know what I mean? I totally.
Like, everything about it was so, like, ridiculously, like, rural 90s. I wouldn't say all the 90s, but, like, the rural kind of, like.
Yeah, it was the Napoleon Dynamite of the 90s, basically.
yeah.
Like, a timepiece like that.
I know it's not a 90s movie, but you reminded me of The Haunted Mansion.
With Eddie Murphy?
Good movie. I'd say that scary as fuck is Silence of the Lambs, bro, if you never saw that.
Oh, I know the SOL, little Silence of the Lambs. Fucking, I get, yeah, that's a
Alien. Alien's a good movie. That movie's pretty fucking scary.
But maybe there are some pretty good horror flicks out there that I'm like.
I like sci-fi a lot, though. I'm a big sci-fi horror. I like Signs. Signs was fucking just ridiculously stupid, but I love it because I love Shyamalan movies.
Who doesn't love
Signs? Have you seen The Village? Like, people hate on The Village so much, but like, I like the Shyamalan twist.
That's Ben Affleck, right? In The Village?
No, I can't say it's for Phoenix.
Joaquin Phoenix. Oh, right. I'm thinking the town with Ben Affleck.
Bro, The Village is like critically hated upon, but I thought it was fucking crazy. You watch the end of that movie, it's like, what the fuck?
Critically, it's just Joaquin Phoenix just talking shit on it. That's the only one that's talking
I don't want to spoil the movie. Have you seen the movie?
I have not. No, I have not seen The Village. I've seen Signs, like, but I've not seen The Village. No, I'm not. You can spoiler alert.
Like, at the end of like the whole movie, you think it's like the 1800s and these people are like living in like fucking like some village somewhere, but it's really like present day and they're just hiding from society, but they don't tell anyone there. And they tell the people that there's these evil demons in the forest surrounding them.
I've heard of this concept, the whole movie, you don't know this.
Like, you're led to believe that that there really are horrible demons out in the forest trying to kill them.
Oh, so your perspective is inside the village and it's coming. Yeah. Oh, that's very Shyamalan. That sounds like an M. Night Shyamalan.
Yeah, it's fucking dope. I thought it was a great move. People hate on it. I'm like, take it for what it was. It was a mind fuck. Like, no, it didn't have any profound thing. It wasn't great. Like, I guess it criticizes like Amish culture a little. I don't know.
Maybe,
yeah, like, or they seem very Amish.
Like Amish. Yeah. They're Amish, I guess you could say.
Yeah.
They're Amish. Like,
they were more like you had the sense that it had to be like 1825.
So like when I think Amish, I just think instantly like the classics, like, you know, no electricity, like, yeah,
churn in some water. Do Amish people smoke weed? Is that fine? I don't see why they can't. Like, it's like,
I think they do.
The Amish people burn. Hell yeah.
I think they smoke a lot of everything.
Maybe they don't
indulge, because I'm pretty sure Amish people like don't indulge in like pleasurable things. They only do things that like suck all the time.
They're like,
isn't that like what it is?
I guess they're just like, look, we're Amish. We don't have fun.
Enjoyment at all. Yeah. Life is work.
Yeah. Jordan.
Yo.
Are you in Tampa Bay right now?
Yeah, I'm in Tampa right now.
How is it, man? I feel like you told me you had a crazy story or something like that when we were off pod, that you said something strange happened to you. Something a little weird.
Yeah, a bunch of strange shit has happened down here, bro.
Well, you're Florida, what's it man. Called? Now, so let's hear what we got from you, buddy.
I went to go and get some liquor, and this guy like approached me, and he was like telling me like blah blah blah, your demeanor, this, that, and the other, the Black Stallion, like just like going off on some like crackhead talk, and then like he was like trying to buy some drink next to me, and he was like, I came for a drink or some dumbass shit. And like, I was like really fed up with him at that point.
Yeah, he was just like, in your ear chirping. He was like, you a Black Stallion, young man. Like, he was just like, yeah,
you really got those? So I've never heard someone like throw something that random out and like, you know, blah, blah, blah. He called me the Black Stallion. Blah, blah.
They're like, oh, my.
Like, it seems like it needs some context.
Yeah, what he was the just. Hell was this guy yeah, saying Jordan's just trip? Like, I don't know what he was saying, but he did call me the Black Stallion at one point.
I'm like 100% sure he called me that too. Like, that's the thing.
Yeah, well, you can't forget that. That's just like, that's just like, I'll never forget that at all.
And then he asked me, what am I doing at the store? And I'm like, I'm buying some drinks. Like, why else would I be at the store?
As you're just locked and loaded with your fucking drinks, you know, like you have it all in you're clear. Yeah, it's like clearly what you're there for, you know.
Yeah. And then he like pulls $10 out of his pocket and he like gives it to me, like high as fuck, just like gives it to me. And I'm like, thank you.
He probably was like, hold up.
Let's break it down. Sorry. This guy comes up to you, calls you the Black Stallion, keeps going off on you, and then gives you $10.
He gave me $10.
Okay.
Something tells me he doesn't just leave after that.
Like, no.
No. No, he does not leave after that. I'm trying to leave after that. And then I see his dumb ass in the fucking van. And him and his wife, they're like mad creepy, bro. He's like asking me if he can like pay for shit for me. And I'm just like, no, I'm good. Like,
wait, is this guy one of those like weird dudes that like, he probably wants you to like bang his wife, Jordan?
I think
that's not happening. That's not happening.
Or he was just like, look at this guy. This guy in the liquor store right now is the Black Stallion, and I have to give him $10. And like, this guy looks like if I give him $10, he might do weird stuff to me. And I think like, I might be able to take this risk right now on this point, you know?
And his wife's yelling at him, like, what are you doing?
She's like, yeah, like, I told you to use that $10. Go inside there. We need to get toilet paper for the house. Like, what the fuck's wrong with you? Or no, she's like, I told you to get, well, you're in a liquor store.
You said they were crackheads, too. So she was probably like, you're supposed to go in there, go to the back, go to the bathroom, put the $10 behind the toilet, grab the crack.
Yeah. And then, but he walked in, saw Jordan, said, holy shit, that's a Black Stallion. and then was like, I gotta give this guy.
I don't like being called that.
Yo. And it's like, but honey, you have to understand. I couldn't resist. I couldn't help myself. So what happens after that? Like, after, like, all, he's still in the van, like, they're still, like, creeping on you, right?
Yeah, he was, like, hanging in my fucking window, bro. And I had to put my car in reverse. And fucking, I had to leave eventually, like, said peace. I think he was, like, trying to traffic, bro.
Which is, like, crazy. I mean, it does sound like that, the way you explained it. Or he was just, like, I wonder if that guy will do some weird stuff for $10. Like, let's just see what he'll do. Like, let's just see the limitations that
we were like 20 minutes from being like in a cage, like on a flight to Bangkok.
But do you still have a $10 bill though? Do you still have the $10?
Someone's gonna come to you and be like, you're forever in our debt.
The guy's gonna be like, hey, you still got my $10? Like, waiting for it. Yeah. This guy's gonna fucking find you and like just fucking get at you, you know?
Thought he was like trying to follow me for a second. I was about to like freak out.
Oh, wow, well, you like, dipped man, out,
like,
man.
Sketchy. Like, that's what I'm starting to realize. There's a lot of sketchy people down here. A lot of sketchy.
A lot of people that just walk into liquor stores and just say, hey, I'm going to give that guy $10 and just like, let's see where we can go from there. But you know what I mean?
Like, what possessed him to go and fucking give me that $10?
What did he buy at the liquor store either?
I bought some vanilla Jim Beam.
No, like, what was he getting? Did he just go in there and give you his money and then walk out and not buy anything?
I didn't see anything in his hands when he approached me, but like,
so this was just a dude in the liquor store, didn't buy anything, left the liquor store. That's probably why his wife was yelling at him. His wife was probably like, you didn't buy anything? He's like, nah, this guy, this kid.
He's just like, nah, fucking. He's like, but honey, look at that guy. Look at that guy. Hey, it's the Black Stallion. It's
the fuck.
What the fuck is going on, man? I would get the hell out of that whole city.
Like, his wife was like, is he okay to drive?
What?
I got a 405.
Dude, we lost Jordan.
No, he'll pop back. He'll pop back. I have faith in him. It's the 2-minute warning anyway. I gotta get so before we have 2 minutes until we run out of time. So
there's so much to unravel with that. We should open with that. Damn.
Yeah, I know. But I guess you know what? We can come back to that next week. And maybe in this span of time, Jordan will have more stories of people just giving him money.
Yeah, I mean, that's great. Yeah.
Yeah. Like, and like,
imagine there's a thing going around like that. Jordan doesn't know about that, like, people just go up to him and give him $10.
Like the Black Stallion.
We should try. Dude, that would be a great way to make money. Like, try to make it a viral thing that, like, wherever you go, people should give you $10.
Ooh.
Get, like, 10 people to do it, fake it. But then, like, when you go out in public, they'll be like, yo, what's the guy?
I think we got to do final grabs without Jordan.
Yeah, I don't think he's coming back.
He dropped out. I think he's fucking done. We have 1 minute anyway, so we have less than a minute till our final grab. We got to run.
Someone just banged on his door. Yo, where my $10?
Yeah, let's rip our last grab, Wooly. We're on a time crunch. This is final grabstination. Superstition.